رمضان قد أهل بالصيام وأطل مسعدا أهلا وخلا ليته في كل حين ليته في كل حين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. Your brother Bilal Ismail of the Al-Kawthar Institute and Imam Development Project, حياكم الله. Bite-sized reminders and information with regards to zakah. يا عبد الله يا أمة الله, A to Z of zakat al-fitr بإذن الله تعالى. A few pointers. Number one, what is the ruling with regards to zakat al-fitr or sadaqat al-fitr? The ulama of the four madhahib of the opinion that it's an obligation upon the Muslim. We find the Hanafi scholars stating that it is wajib, and majority of the ulama stating that it is fard. Number two, when was it legislated? When did it become an obligation upon the Muslims? In the same year, in the same Ramadan, that our normal zakah became an obligation, and that was the second year after the hijrah of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Number three, what are its various names? It's called Sadaqatul Fitr, it's called Zakat al-Fitr, it's called Zakat of Ramadan, Zakat of the month of Ramadan, also called Zakat al-Abdan, Zakat of the body, because it's not so much attached to your wealth, but rather attached to the body. It's also called Fitra, according to many of the awam. It's called Sadaqatul Ra's, the sadaqah which is due upon the head. So these are some of the terms associated and the names associated to zakat al-fitr. The next matter, number four, what are some of the wisdoms behind its legislation? Subhanallah, we find our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam stating that it is طهرةٌ للصائم, purification for the one who had fasted. You might have looked at something, you might have said something, you might have had these blemishes upon your fast. By your paying and sorting out your zakat al-fitr, then it sorts out those blemishes بإذن الله تعالى. He also stated طهرةٌ للصائم من اللغو والرفث and وطعمةٌ للمساكين, and it's some food, it's something good, something nice for the poor on that day. And this hadith reported by Imam Abu Dawood. We also find that the other wisdom behind its legislation, that at least on the day of Eid, the poor and the destitute, they do not have to worry about where's the next meal gonna come from. That at least for this day, they are sorted out, as we will say, that they have this meal, walhamdulillah. Everybody is happy, everybody is merrymaking, everybody is nice and good moods. Well, these people on this day, they don't have to worry, they have their meals provided for them, walhamdulillah. We find the hadith reported by Imam Ad-Darqutni, although it has some weakness in it, أغنوهم عن الطواف في هذا اليوم, that save them, save the poor from making tawaf and going from person to person begging for food, seeking food, save them from this. On the day of Eid, they have enough, walhamdulillah. The other wisdom, subhanallah, is that as we will learn, zakat al-fitr, it does not have any nisab, and that's the opinion of majority of the ulama. Zakat al-fitr, as long as you have excess food in your home, more than you require for the day on Eid, then you need to sort out zakat al-fitr. You might not be a millionaire, you are in reality from the poor, subhanallah. All you have is enough food to sort you out for today and the next 3 days. Do you need to sort out zakat al-fitr? Yes, you need to. But I'm poor, but I'm destitute. Just because I have more than enough food for this day, I need to pay? Yes, you need to pay. You need to sort it out. And in fact, subhanallah, there's a tarbiyah lesson in this matter, that this gives the person who is poor, this gives the destitute also the opportunity to be the hand which is giving, walhamdulillah. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we'll talk about, it's an obligation upon whom? It's an obligation upon every single Muslim out there. Be you young, be you old, male, female, husband, wife, even the slave, subhanAllah, the master will sort it out. And the master, be it the kid, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, every Muslim needs to sort out Zakat al-Fitr condition. According to majority of the ulama, if you have more than enough food for the day of Eid, then you need to sort out Zakat al-Fitr. As for the Hanafi scholars, they apply the principle of the Nisab, which we apply in normal Zakah. They apply it here too, that if you are a person of Nisab, then you sort out Zakat al-Fitr. And if you do not have the Nisab, you do not have to pay the Zakat al-Fitr. That's the opinion of the Hanafi scholars. The next point, Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, that when does it become an obligation upon me? When does it become an obligation upon me? According to majority of the ulama, the night of Eid, which is obviously the evening before the Eid, Jayid. And so the night before Eid, or as we will call it, the night of Eid, once the moon has been sighted, etc., then with the setting of that sun, it became an obligation upon you, according to majority of the ulama. As for the Hanafi scholars, they state that with true dawn the following day, the day of Eid, when the time of Salatul Fajr comes in, that's when it becomes an obligation upon you. What's the fa'idah of this? The fa'idah of this is that if a person, according to majority of the ulama, passed away before the night of Eid, then there's no Zakat al-Fitr which is due upon him. Nobody needs to sort it out from the estate, etc. But if after you passed away, subhanAllah, you know, on the morning of the day of Eid, you need to sort out, or rather from your estate, they would need to sort this matter out, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. When's the final time for me to pay? You need to pay it before Salatul Eid. You need to have this paid before Salatul Eid. Can I begin payment? Can I sort it out, let's say, on the 20th of Ramadan, 25th of Ramadan? Yes, brother, no problem at all. That's in fact recommended. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, he used to sort out his Zakat al-Fitr 1 or 2 days before Eid. And so that's the better thing. Walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we discussed it's an obligation upon every Muslim out there. In fact, Uthman al-Ghani, Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, he would say that even for the woman who's pregnant, for the unborn fetus, sort out Zakat al-Fitr on behalf of that fetus too, subhanAllah. And so for the entire family, the father, the head of the household, can sort it out for all of them. Or if they themselves individually want to sort out the Zakat al-Fitr, then they can pay on their own behalf, walhamdulillah. Who do I give my Zakat al-Fitr to? We find that the normal Zakah, Surah Tawbah, verse number 60, mentions 8 categories of Zakah recipients. And many of the ulama state that Zakat al-Fitr we also give to those 8 categories. But there are other ulama who said, no, there's a difference between normal Zakah and Zakat al-Fitr. Zakat al-Fitr, we only give to 2 categories, the fuqara and the masakeen, those who are poor and those who are the miskeen. And those 2 categories are the ones who can receive and nobody else. So this is a mas'ala of debate amongst the ulama, walhamdulillah. Abdullah ibn Umar, he states, فرض رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة الفطر صاع من تمر. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم obligated upon them a saw of dates. What's a saw? What's the amount that I need to sort out in زكاة الفطر? When you put your hands together, the ordinary individual putting the hands together, whatever dates can be held in your hand, this we would call a mud. Times this by 4, it equals a saw. So put your hands together, fill it up with rice. Or with dates, 1, and then a 2nd, and then a 3rd, and then a 4th. This now would equal 1 saw. 4 muds equal to 1 saw. And what you need to give as Zakat al-Fitr, 1 saw of dates, or of barley, or of raisins, or of cheese, or of wheat. These were some of the items mentioned by the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sa'an min tamar, or sa'an min sha'ir, ala al-abdi wal-hur. Upon who? Upon the slave, upon the free, upon the dhakar, upon the untha, upon the saghir, upon the kabir, min al-muslimin, of the Muslims. وأمر بها أن تؤدى قبل خروج الناس إلى الصلاة. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered that it should be paid before you leave to go out for Salat al-Eid, because we want to have the poor and the destitute free of need on the day of Eid. And so pay it before bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. Take note, brothers and sisters, that the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us this measure, this amount, and this was technically the sa', which is of volume. Today we don't really work with the volume, but rather we work with kilograms. So one needs to convert this from volume to kilograms. An example of volume, your liters, etc. Now we want to convert the sa' into kilograms, and the ulama have debated on the exact amount of the sa', because it would vary. The answers would be different. What volume are you talking about? Volume of rice would equate different number of kilograms. Volume of rice would equate a different number of kilograms. Volume of water would equate a different number of kilograms. Ala kulli hal, we find that many of the ulama go with 2 kilograms and 0.36 kilograms. That seems to be what majority of the ulama are upon today. As for some of the Malikis, 2.28 kilograms. As for the Hanafi scholars, they go with 3.13 kilograms. You have, for example, Sheikh Salman Al-Awda going with 2.2 kilograms. The Hay'a Kibar Ulama of Saudi Arabia, Council of Senior Scholars, state that go with 3 kilograms to be on the safe side. So, ala kulli hal, 2.5 kilograms is like an average. And we said majority of the contemporary scholars go with 2.36 kilograms. Walhamdulillah. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah. So that's the amount bi-ithnillahi ta'ala once we convert it into kilograms. We find that many of the Malikis and the Shafi'i scholars stating that although these five items were mentioned in the hadith, the common denominator between them is that they were staple food items. So in your country, whatever the staple food item might be, you can pay that as the Zakatul Fitr. Rice was not mentioned, but today in many countries, rice is part and parcel of the staple diet. And so you can sort it out in rice. And that opinion also a very good opinion, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. We find that the Hanafi scholars of the opinion that you do not have to sort out one saw, but rather half a saw would suffice. Majority of the ulama stating you need to give the amount of one saw, 1, 2, 3, 4 muds equaling to one saw, or as we said, majority of the scholars, 2.36 kilograms. The Hanafis go with half that amount. Why? Because during the time of Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an, with regards to wheat, he had said that half a saw would suffice. And there were many other Sahaba who were also of this opinion. And so the Hanafi scholars go with half a sa', and majority of the scholars go with one sa'. And that's why, you know, brothers might ask, sisters might ask, I find that the Shafi'is mention a certain value and the Hanafis have a different value. Why is the Hanafi value a bit cheaper? Well, because they are working it out upon half a sa', whereas majority are working it out upon one full sa', which is 2.36 kilograms. And Hanafis, according to them, one sa' is plus minus 3.13, and so half of that they would be going with plus minus 1.5 kilograms. So that's where the difference comes in. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, what about paying my Zakat al-Fitr in cash? Is that something allowed or is it not allowed? Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, we find that our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had mentioned these food items. And we found that the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they would continue upon their practice. We find majority of the ulama, the Shafi'is, the Malikis, the Hanbalis, they say, no, you have to stick to food. They might have expanded it to include rice and other items which are not mentioned in the hadith, because they said that these are the staple food items. But going outside the realm of food, they do not allow it. Cannot be done in cash.
As for the Hanafi scholars, they allow for an individual to pay their zakat al-fitr in cash. Who's of this opinion? The minority opinion, the Hanafi madhab, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, the great Khalifa of the Muslims at one time, Sufyan al-Thawri, Hassan al-Basri from amongst the contemporaries, Sheikh Mustafa al-Zarqa, Sheikh Salman al-Awda, and many others are from amongst the contemporary scholars of the opinion that paying in cash would be fine. What's the proof of majority? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned food items, so we stop where he stopped. They mentioned the aim and objective behind this is to provide food for the poor, and so give them the food. They also mentioned that the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned food items, which in reality were of different values in terms of cash. The dates different from the value of the raisins, different from the value of the wheat, and all of these matters. Had cash been allowed, which cash value would you use? The value of the dates, or the value of the raisins, or the value of the barley? Which one? You're gonna have confusion, subhanAllah. So they said, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned different items, all food items. We stick and we stop where they had stopped. What are some of the proofs of the Hanafi scholars? They said, subhanAllah, number one, that these ahadith which talk and mention the zakatul fitr items, they are from the ahadith of action and not from the ahadith of statement from the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And ahadith of action are of a lower level in terms of strength of proof than the ahadith of statement. Statement is obviously given preference. So they said these ahadith are not on the level of statement but are on the level of action. They also said that there's nothing to prevent us giving cash. There's nothing to prevent. There's no hadith or any proof to say that we cannot give in cash. They also mentioned that maybe this is even better. Maybe the poor individual wants cash. Maybe he does not want to eat dates, does not want to eat rice. Maybe he wants something else. So give him the money and he can do with it whatever he feels and sees fit. They said that we have Salaf for this matter. We have precedent. We have scholars of the past who also said this. You had Umar bin Abdul Aziz, who was the Khalifa of the Muslims, and he was of that opinion. Walhamdulillah. They also mentioned that with regards to our normal zakah, the basic default rule is that with regards to animals, you pay from your animals. So you have 1,000 sheep, you sort out your zakah from the animals. But you are allowed to go on to paying with cash due to haja. Maybe, for example, there's a certain situation, you can pay it in cash. So they said if that's allowed there, then obviously in zakat al-fitr, which is on a lower level of importance, it should obviously be allowed here too. So they made this qiyas. Then we find, subhanAllah, they said that sometimes you find, and this is quite apparent, especially in the Gulf countries, you find that there's this female, poor female, and so people buy the zakat al-fitr amount of dates, and then they give it to her. And she collects from Salim, Ahmed, Ilyas, Suleiman, all of these people, she's collected 10 packages of dates. What's she gonna do with so much of dates? What does she do? She takes it, she goes to the shop, and she sells it back to the shopkeeper for a lower price, subhanAllah. And if it was 20 riyals, they will give her 15 riyals, and then she takes the cash and she does with it whatever she needs. So these scholars are saying, rather you give her the 20 riyals straight at the beginning, then giving her dates worth 20, she then sells it to the shopkeeper for 15, and then she gets back 15 in her hands and does with it whatever she wants. Rather sort out that matter, make it easy, give her the 20 riyals in cash, walhamdulillah. They also mention that rice is not mentioned in this hadith, and many of the majority of ulama, the Shafi'is and Malikis, allow payment with rice. So these Hanafi scholars and others, they said, if you want to stick to the text, then stick to only what the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned. Do not allow rice. If you're going to make qiyas and you're going to allow rice, then also allow paying in cash. So these were some of the proofs of the Hanafi scholars. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. They also mentioned one last proof, and they said that the fact that Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he allowed half a sa' was due to the fact that he saw the value and the price of half a sa' would equate one sa' of the other items. So they said, look, Muawiyah was looking at value, he was looking at price, and so paying in cash would obviously be allowed bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. Ya Abdallah, ya Amat Allah. This is the matter of Zakat al-Fitr and Sadaqat al-Fitr. If the individual wants to pay the food items, Alhamdulillah, khairan barakah. And if a brother or a sister wants to sort it out in cash, no problem, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Even Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he allowed it with certain conditions, condition of hajah, etc., etc. There is salaf, there is precedent to this opinion. No problem, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Can I delegate an organization, a foundation, etc., to sort out the Zakat al-Fitr on my behalf? No problem at all. They are your agent. It's as if you gave your friend the money, pay it on my behalf, and he can do this. Make sure that they sort it out and they have the distribution done before the time of Salat, Salat al-Eid, walhamdulillah. Can myself, my cousin, my uncle, my grandfather, my daughter, my son, all of us pay and sort out our Zakat al-Fitr to one individual, one poor individual? Yes, you can, no problem. 1,000 people can give their Zakat al-Fitr to one individual, no problem at all. Can somebody who is also paying Zakat al-Fitr collect Zakat al-Fitr? Yes, 100%. Example, somebody 3 days before Eid, 5 people came to him and they gave him each, you know, 2 kilograms or 5 kilograms of dates. In fact, now in his house, he's probably got 35 kilograms of dates. On the day of Eid, technically, does this brother have more than he needs for the day of Eid? Yes, he has more food than he needs. So he needs to also sort out his own Zakat al-Fitr, alhamdulillah. And we mentioned the Hanafi scholars attach Zakat al-Fitr to the matter of Nisab, whereas majority do not. Majority, as long as you have enough food for the day, you need to sort out your Zakat al-Fitr, alhamdulillah. What happens if I've not paid my Zakat al-Fitr by the time Salatul Eid begins? Then in reality, you can sort it out after Salatul Eid, but you will not get that reward as it being Zakat al-Fitr. It will be like any other charity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us khair and barakah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who fulfill our obligations on time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who are the maqbooleen, those who have been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hayyakum Allah, until we meet again. Jazakum Allah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
رمضان قد أهل بالصيام وأطل مسعدا أهلا وخلا لتهو في كل حين لتهو في كل حين.